Imagine you're sending a letter to your friend. You write their country, state, city, and finally their house number. Without a correct address, your letter won't reach them. Well, computers, PLCs, and industrial devices communicate in the same way. They need a unique address called an IP address to communicate properly. If you get it wrong, nothing works. In this video, we are going to learn what an IP address is and why it is important in industrial automation. Let's get started now. Welcome back to Mr. Smart. An IP, or Internet Protocol Address, is a unique identifier for a device on a network, and it looks like this. It consists of four octets, each ranging from 0 to 255. Think of an IP address like a home address for your device. But why is the range only 0 to 255? A computer, or any machine, understands only binary language, which is either 0 or 1, technically called bits. An IP address is also binary in its original form. It is made up of 32 bits, divided into 4 parts, with each part having 8 bits. That's why each part is called an octet. Mathematically, an octet can have 256 different binary combinations, ranging from 0 to 255. This is the reason why each part of an IP address has values from 0 to 255. A little deep, but necessary for a smart person. Let's get back to understanding what an IP address is. In the four octets of an IP address, the first octet defines the network class, the next two octets define the subnetworks, and the last octet defines the specific device in that network. To explain it more simply, it's similar to a real-world address. The first octet is like your country. The second octet is like your state. The third octet is like your area or city. And the last octet is like your house. Just like a mailman needs your full address to deliver a package, a PLC or any device in a network needs an IP address to communicate with a PC or other devices. But that alone is not enough to establish successful communication. There are so many countries in the world, so many states in a country, and so many areas or cities in a state. It would be difficult to locate a house if we don't know where exactly to look. The same scenario applies to industrial network communication. In addition to an IP address, you need an invisible fence called a subnet mask. This limits the number of choices you need to search through to find a device in a network. The subnet mask decides which addresses are in your neighborhood and which ones are far away. For example, the subnet mask 255.255.255.0 means the first three octets are completed and it represents your neighborhood. That is, they belong to the same network. The last octet represents your house. That is, the specific device you are trying to connect to. Which means this subnet mask allows two devices with same first three octets but different last octet to communicate. And what does it mean if the subnet mask is 255.255.254.0? Here, the third octet is not complete. It is not 255. It still has one more possibility available. In simple words, you need to look for the house in at least two areas inside your state and country. This makes the network a little bigger, but it also makes it harder to locate the device because the search area is wider. So, remember, the fewer the digits in the subnet, the bigger the network becomes. Now, Think like you are in need to send a letter to another country? You can't just drop it in your local mailbox. And that's where the gateway comes in. A gateway is the device that sends data outside your network to other networks. For example, your PC's IP is 192.168.1.10, and your PLC's IP is 192.168.1.11. As they are in same network, they have direct communication. Your gateway is the router or switch that connects to external networks, and having an IP as 192.168.1.1. If your PC or PLC wants to communicate with a machine having a different IP as 10.0.0.5, it must go through the gateway first. If there's no gateway set, there will be no communication. And if you don't want communication outside your network, no gateway is needed. That's easy, right? If you're an automation engineer, understanding IP addresses, subnet masks, and gateways is like being the postmaster of your industrial network, making sure every device gets the right message. Hope this video was simple and helpful to you. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell for more automation tips. Thanks for watching. See you soon, Mr. Smart Family.